Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject hidden mass transfer. Today, this is lecture number 109 on the topic conduction heat transfer. The topic for today's discussion is the steady state heat transfer in cylinder and the sphere with the heat generation. Earlier, we derived the general heat transfer equation for a polar coordinate system, and using that, we will solve the steady. We will discuss the steady state heat transfer in cylinder and the sphere with the heat generation. The learning outcome for this lecture is the student will be able to solve problem in cylinder and the sphere with the heat generation. And first we will take up one dimensional steady state heat transfer in a cylinder with the heat generation. And this is the general heat conduction equation for a cylindrical coordinate system. And we will simplify this equation for the present situation. The present situation is one dimensional steady state heat transfer in a cylinder with the heat generation. So it is one dimensional. So we consider the heat transfer only in the radial direction. So the heat transfer in the asymptotical direction and the axial direction are dropped. And this is steady state heat transfer. So we drop the term for temperature variation with respect to time. So the two dimensional parameters are dropped. The time parameter is also dropped. Finally, this is the equation for the present situation. One dimensional steady state heat transfer in a cylinder with the heat generation. So here Q dot is the volumetric heat generation, the heat generation per unit volume. K is the thermal conductivity of the material. And we will consider a cylinder, solid cylinder of radius R, outer radius R. And here we have uniform heat generation at the rate of Q dot, and TW is the wall temperature. And we take the boundary condition at R equal to 0 at the center, the temperature will be constant. So the first derivative dT by dR equal to 0. So at the center, dT by dR equal to 0. On the outer surface, where R equal to capital R and the temperature equal to wall temperature, surface temperature or wall temperature. So these are all the boundary condition, and this is your governing equation. So we have to solve the governing equation within the boundary condition. So mathematics, we integrate the equation. So the initial equation is 1 by R dou by dou R, R into dou T by dou R plus Q dot by K equal to 0. We rearrange 1 by R dou by dou R into dou T by dou R equal to minus Q dot by K. We take this R to the right side. So, dou by dou R into dou T by dou R equal to minus Q dot by K into R. Integrating the first time, R into dou T by dou R equal to minus Q dot by K, integrating R, R square by 2 plus the constant of integration. Now, once again simplify, R, you take this R to the right side. So, dou T by dou R equal to minus Q dot by K, R by 2 plus C1 by R. Integrating again. T equal to Q dot by 2K into R square by 2 plus C1 into logarithmic R plus C2. So simplifying, rearranging. So T equal to minus Q dot by 4K into R square plus C1 logarithmic of R plus C2. So here we have two constants, C1 and C2. We have two boundary conditions. So using those boundary conditions, we have to find out what is the value of the C1 and C2. Using the boundary condition. So first we take the boundary condition at R equal to 0, dT by dR equal to 0. So you take dT by dR is here. So left hand side equal to 0, R equal to the first term is also 0. So C1 is 0. Finally, what is conclusion of the first boundary condition? C1 equal to 0. So this term is dropped. T1 is dropped. Now what is left out at R equal to capital R? The wall temperature T equal to TW, the temperature term C1 is dropped. So remaining term is T equal to minus Q dot by 4K into R square plus C2. So taking up the boundary condition, TW equal to minus Q dot by 4K into capital R square plus C2. So C2 equal to TW plus Q dot by 4K in R square. So C1 equal to 0 and C2 equal to TW plus Q dot by 4K R square. So substituting the constant in the temperature distribution equation, so the temperature distribution becomes T equal to minus Q dot by 4K small r square plus TW plus Q dot by 4K capital R square, rearranging TW plus Q dot by 4K into capital R square minus small r square. So this is the temperature distribution equation. Using this equation, we can determine the temperature at any radius of the cylinder from the center. R equal to 0 at the center, R equal to capital R at the outer surface. And we calculate the center temperature putting substituting R equal to 0. So TO, center temperature, equal to TW plus Q dot R square divided by 4K. Now the rate of heat transfer, Q equal to minus KA dT by dR at R equal to capital R, outer surface. Heat is transferred towards the outer surface. So Q equal to minus KA dT by dR at R equal to capital R. So substituting minus K into A equal to 2 pi R into L into the dT by dR. So dT by dR at R equal to minus Q dot capital R divided by 2K, simplifying pi R square into L into Q dot. So the pi R square into L equal to the volume of the cylinder, and the Q dot is the amount of heat generation per unit volume. Now we consider the convection environment. We take a cylinder and the cylinder surface is exposed to the convective condition. H is the heat transfer coefficient and T infinity is the fluid temperature. So in this situation, heat conducted to the outer wall equal to heat convected to the fluid. So heat conducted to the outer wall equal to minus KA into dT by dR, which is equal to heat convected to the fluid HA into TW minus T infinity. So the heat conducted earlier we calculated pi r square L into Q dot equal to 2 into 2 pi r into L into TW minus T infinity. So simplifying, the surface temperature, wall temperature equal to T infinity plus Q dot R by 2H. So the equation, final equation, TW equal to T infinity plus Q dot R by 2H is important. The center temperature is important and the amount of heat transfer is important. So these are all the three equations important to solve the problem further. So we take up a numerical example. Example number one, a 3 millimeter wire of thermal conductivity 19 watts per meter Kelvin at a steady heat generation rate of 5000 megawatt per meter cube. Determine the center temperature if the outside temperature is maintained at 25 degree Celsius. So after reading the problem, we write the given data. So the given data, radius of the cylinder, R equal to 1.5 into 10 power minus 3 meter. Thermal conductivity of the material is 19 watts per meter Kelvin. And the surface temperature TW equal to 25 degree Celsius. And rate of heat generation is 500 into 10 power 6 watts per meter cube. So we have determined the center temperature. The center temperature equal to TW plus Q dot R square by 4K, which is 25 plus, substituting numerical value, 25 plus 500 into 10 power 6 into 1.5 10 power minus 3 whole square divided by 4 into 19. Calculating the value, the temperature at the center will be 39.8 degree Celsius. We take another example, an electrical resistance wire of radius 1 millimeter with thermal conductivity of 25 watts per meter Kelvin is heated by passage of electric current, which generates heat within the wire at a constant rate of 2 into 10 power 9 watts per meter cube. Determine the center line temperature rise above the surface temperature. So the given data, radius of the wire is 1 into 10 power minus 3 meter and thermal conductivity of the wire is 25 watts per meter Kelvin. Rate of heat generation is 2 into 10 power 9 watts per meter cube. Then we have to calculate rise in temperature above the surface temperature. So TO minus TW. So TO is the center temperature and TW is the wall temperature. So rise in temperature above the wall temperature, TO minus T infinity equal to Q dot R square by 4K. this equal to 2 into 10 power 9 into 10, 1 into 10 power minus 3 volt to the power 2 divided by 4 into 25, which is equal to 20 degree Celsius. So the rise in temperature, difference in temperature between center and the surface temperature is 20 degree Celsius. We take another important example with the practical application from the university question paper May 2010. An internally cooled copper conductor of 2 cm outer radius and 0.75 cm inner radius carries a current density of 5000 ampere per centimeter square. A constant temperature of 70 degree Celsius is maintained at the inner surface and there is no heat transfer through the insulation surrounding the copper wire. Set up an equation for temperature distribution through the copper. Proceed to calculate the maximum temperature of the copper and radius at which it occurs. Also find the internal heat transfer rate and check the value equal to the total energy generation by the in the conductor. So for copper, thermal conductivity is 380 watts per meter Kelvin and resistivity equal to 2 into 10 power minus 8 ohm meter. So we consider this hollow cylinder. So internally cooled hollow cylinder, the metal is copper. So there is heat generation at the rate of 5000 amperes per centimeter square. You write down the data, heat generation is 5000 amperes per centimeter square. This is equal to 5000 into 10 power minus 4 amperes per meter square area. So R1 inner radius is 0.75 centimeter, which is 0.0075 meter. R2 is the outer radius 2 centimeter, which is 0.02 meter. Temperature on the inner surface is 70 degree Celsius, where R equal to R1 and K is thermal conductive material 380 watts per meter Kelvin and resistivity of the wire is 2 into 10 power minus 8 ohm meter. So the temperature distribution equation for cylinder with the heat generation. So this we already derived, earlier we derived this equation T equal to minus Q dot by 4 K R square plus C1 into logarithmic R plus C2. Now, the C1, C2 value, the constants that we have to find out. Now, the boundary conditions for the present problem, T equal to T1 at R equal to R1. And at R equal to R2, it is insulated. So, dT by dR equal to 0. That is what given here. So, maintain inner surface and there is no heat transfer through the insulation surrounding the copper. So, the outer surface is insulated. So, there is no heat transfer, dT by dR equal to 0. So, R equal to, at R equal to R. And you find out the dT by dR from the the temperature distribution equation, dT by dR equal to minus QR by Q dot by 4K into 2R plus C1 by R. So, differentiating logarithmic R, it is 1 by R. So, dT by dR equal to 0 at R equal to R2. So, Q dot minus Q dot by 2K into R2 plus C1 by R2. So, C1 equal to Q dot by 2K into R2 square. So, this is the value of C1. And taking the second boundary condition, so T equal to T1 at R equal to R1. So, T1 equal to minus Q dot by 4K into R1 square plus Q dot by 2K R2 square plus logarithmic of R1. So, C1 equal to Q dot by 2K R2 square and logarithmic of R1 plus C2. So, C2 equal to T1 plus Q dot by 4K R1 square minus Q dot by 2K R2 square into logarithmic of R1. So, C1, C2 values we have substituting the temperature distribution equation. So, substituting T equal to Q dot by 4K R square as it is C1 Q dot by 2K R2 square into logarithmic of R plus C2. So, T1 plus Q dot by 4K R1 square minus Q dot by 2K R2 square logarithmic of R1. So, simplifying this equation, temperature distribution in the cylinder, in the hollow cylinder, T equal to T1 in T1 plus Q dot by 2K multiplied by R1 square minus R square by 2 plus R2 square into logarithmic of R by R1. This is the temperature distribution equation for the present boundary conditions. Now, the heat generation per unit to volume. So, Q dot equal to I square R divided by the volume. So, I square R is the heat generation and per unit volume A into L. This is resistance of the wire equal to rho into L by A. Rho is the resistivity, L is the length of the wire and A is the cross-sectional area of the wire. So, I square into rho into L by A divided by AL. Now, L is getting cancelled. So, I square into rho by A divided by the A. So this Q dot equal to I square by A square. So I by A whole square into rho. So I by A is the current density per unit area. So this value is given as 5,000 × 10⁴ ampere per meter square. So 5,000 × 10⁴ into resistivity equal to 2 × 10⁻⁸. So the volumetric heat generation within the solid, within the copper wire, is 50 × 10⁶ watts per metric. And the maximum temperature will occur at the radius R2 because it is insulated. So the outer radius is insulated with the plastic material. So the outer radius will have the surface, outer surface will have the maximum temperature. So in this equation, in the temperature equation, substituting R equal to R2, maximum temperature equal to T1 plus Q dot by 2K into R1 square minus R2 square by 2 plus R2 square into logarithmic of R2 by R1. Substituting all the numerical values, the maximum temperature on the outer surface equal to 84.5 degree Celsius. Then rate of heat transfer minus Q equal to minus Ka dT by dr at R equal to R1. So we have to calculate the heat transfer from the inner surface and calculate T equal to, you have the equation, T1 plus Q dot by 2K R1 square minus R square by 2 plus R2 square into logarithmic of R by R1. Finding the dT by dr Q dot by 2K into minus 2R divided by 2 plus R2 square into 1 by R. So dT by dr, simplifying this, Q dot by 2K R2 square by R1 minus R1. So substituting the values, dT by dr equal to 3015.35, and the heat transfer equal to minus Ka into dT by dr minus K into 2 pi R1 into L into dT by dr. So minus 380 into 2 pi into 0.0075 into 1 into 3015.35 equal to 53,968.7 watts per meter. So the answers for the problem, the maximum temperature occurs at the outer radius, which is equal to 84.5 degree Celsius, and the rate of heat transfer equal to minus of 53,968.7 watts per meter length of the wire. Now we take one dimensional steady state heat transfer in a sphere with the heat generation, and this is the general heat conduction equation for the sphere. So all the three directions, radial direction, asymptotic direction, polar direction, and unsteady state term and Q dot term. Now we have to simplify this equation for the present situation. This is one dimensional. So presently it is one dimensional steady state heat transfer. So one dimensional. So the polar direction, asymptotic direction terms are dropped. Unsteady state temperature variation with respect to time is also dropped. So the remaining equation is 1 by R square dou by dou R, R square into dou T by dou R plus Q dot by K equal to 0. This is the governing equation for the present situation. One dimensional steady state heat transfer in a sphere with the heat generation. Now we take a sphere of outer radius R with the surface temperature TW in which there is a heat generation Q dot, volumetric heat generation Q dot. And the boundary conditions, as in the previous case, at R equal to 0, dT by dr equal to 0. At the center, the temperature is constant. So, first derivative equal to 0. And R equal to R, the temperature equal to wall temperature, TW. And integrating the equation, so 1 by the basic equation is 1 by R square dou by dou R, R square into dou T by dou R plus Q dot by K equal to 0. This also rearranging the equation, 1 by R square dou by dou R, R square into dou T by dou R equal to Q dot by K, and take the R square to the right side, dou by dou R, R square into dou T by dou R equal to minus Q dot by K R square. So integrating first time, R square dou T by dou R equal to minus Q by K, integrating R square R to the power 3 by 3 plus C1 constant of integration, and you take R square to the right side, dou T by dou R equal to minus Q dot by K R by 3 plus C1 by R square. Integrating again, T equal to minus Q dot by 3K R square by 2 plus C1 into minus 1 by R plus C2, and finally temperature distribution equal to minus Q dot by 6K into R square minus C1 by R plus C2. Now, taking the boundary condition, the first boundary condition at R equal to 0, dT by dR equal to 0. So, that leads to C1 equal to 0 as in the cylinder. And we take the temperature distribution equation now, T equal to minus Q dot by 6K R square plus C2. And taking the second boundary condition, T equal to TW at R equal to capital R. So, TW equal to minus Q dot by 6K plus R into R square plus C2. So, C2 equal to TW plus Q dot by 6K R square. So, we have C2 term and the C1 equal to 0. Substituting in the temperature distribution equation, we will calculate the temperature distribution. So, T equal to minus Q dot by 6K R square plus TW plus Q dot by 6K capital R square. So, the final temperature distribution equation, T equal to TW plus Q dot by 6K into R square minus small r square. And using this equation, we can determine the temperature at any given radius of the sphere. And let us calculate the center temperature. At the center, radius equal to 0. So, in the previous equation, substitute R equal to 0. So, TO equal to TW plus Q dot capital R square by 6K. And we calculate the rate of heat transfer. So, rate of heat transfer equal to minus KA dT by dR at R equal to capital R. So, we calculate dT by dR from this equation for given radius. So, Q equal to minus K into 4 pi R square is the area of the surface area of the sphere minus Q dot R divided by 3K. And simplifying, the heat transfer rate equal to 4 by 3 pi R cube into Q dot. So, where 4 by 3 pi R cube is the volume of the sphere. And we take the convective condition right now. So, we assume the heat is generated and it is conducted towards the outer wall, and from the outer surface the heat is convected to the surrounding. Now, for the convective environment or convection environment, the amount heat conducted to the outer wall is equal to heat conducted to the fluid. So, minus Ka dT by dR equal to Ha into TW minus T infinity. So, the first term we calculated earlier, 4 by 3 pi R cube into Q dot. And the second term on the right hand side, H into area equal to 4 pi R square into TW minus T infinity. So, simplifying, we write TW equal to T infinity plus Q dot R by 3H. So, this wall temperature we can calculate using this equation. Center temperature we can calculate and rate of heat transfer we can calculate. So, the three equations, center temperature, rate of heat transfer and the wall temperature. These are the equation, important equation to solve the problem. And if we take one numerical example, a stainless steel sphere, thermal conductivity K equal to 16 watts per meter Kelvin, having a diameter of 4 centimeter, is exposed to the convection environment at 10 degrees Celsius and the heat transfer coefficient 15 watts per meter square Kelvin. The heat is generated uniformly at the rate of 1 kilowatts per meter cube. Calculate this temperature at the center of the sphere. So, read the problem carefully and write down the given data. So, K, thermal conductivity K equal to 16 watts per meter Kelvin, radius equal to 0.02 meter, fluid temperature is 10 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 15 watts per meter square Kelvin, and heat generator is 1000 watts per meter cube, and the center temperature TO equal to T infinity plus Q dot R divided by 3H plus Q dot R square by 6K, substituting numerical values and calculating the temperature at the center will be 20.44 degree Celsius. And these are all the books I referred for the preparation of the notes, and you can also reach to it for further clarification. I have written a book on the subject. You can find the book, you can find more number of solutions, a numerical example and the theory in this book. And if you have any queries on the subject, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. Thank you. We will meet again.